हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम डॉक्टर सचिन नरवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट GVM गर्ल्स कॉलेज सोनीपत, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी. सो टुडे माय टॉपिक इज़ एम्ब्रियो कल्चर एंड एम्ब्रियो रेस्क्यू. वी विल स्टार्ट विद द कंटेंट मैटर, दैट इज़ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो कल्चर, एम्ब्रियो रेस्क्यू, मेथड ऑफ एम्ब्रियो कल्चर, स्टेप ऑफ एम्ब्रियो कल्चर, एप्लीकेशंस, एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस, एंड देर आर सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू. We will start with the introduction. So, before going to embryo culture, we know about the embryo. What is embryo? So, embryo is a seed plant. Okay, it is a part of a seed or consisting of precursor tissues for the leaves, stems, and roots, as well as one or more cotyledons. Okay, so the young sporophyte of a seed plant usually comprising a rudimentary plant with plumules, radicles, and the cotyledons. Now, what is embryo culture? Embryo culture is a component of in vitro fertilization, where it is in result embryos are allowed to grow for some time in an artificial medium. Or we can say that embryo culture is the sterile isolation and growth of immature or mature embryo in vitro with the goal of obtaining a viable plant. So the first attempt, or we can say that the embryo culture, it is also a type of a plant tissue culture that is used to grow embryo from seed and ovules in a nutrient medium. Okay, so in embryo culture, the plant develop directly from the embryo or indirectly from the formation of callus and then subsequent formation of shoot and the root. Other than this, we can also say that embryo culture similarly can mean the growth of any species during its embryonic stage. It is an artificial medium in order to enhance its likelihood. Okay, or we say that the embryo culture can also mean for the artificial medium for embryonic growth, as we discussed earlier, which can last for the 2 to 5 days, and after which the embryo is transplanted into a surrogate mother. Then before going through this embryo culture method, first we know about that the first attempt to grow the embryo of angiosperm was made by the Hanging in 1904, who obtained viable plant from in vitro isolated embryo of two cruciferae, that is Cochlearia and the Raphanus. Okay, then after that in 1924, Dietrich grew the embryo of different plant species and established that mature embryo grew normally, failed to achieve the organization of a mature embryo. After that, the Liebeck in 1925 isolated intraspecific hybrid embryo of Linum perenne and the Linum ostracum. The seeds are greatly shriveled, very light, and incapable of germination when planted in soil. So they grew directly. Okay, or we can say that it is a practical demonstration for the application that the technique is growing the isolating the embryo of intraspecific crosses. So this led the Liebeck to suggest that in all crosses where viable seeds are not formed, it may be appropriate to excise their embryo and to grow them in an artificial nutrient medium. So embryo culture is now well established branch of a plant tissue culture. So we can excise embryo from such seed and growing them in moist filter paper or cotton soaked in 15% glucose solution. So he was able to raise the hybrid plant. Now what is embryo rescue? See, embryo rescue involves the culture of immature embryo to rescue them from the unripe or hybrid seed which failed to germinate. So it plays an important role in modern plant breeding and ornamental plant crop hybrid. So the most widely used embryo rescue procedure is referred to as an embryo culture, and it involves the excising of the plant embryo and placing them onto the media culture. So in short, we say that embryo rescue is the culture of immature embryo so that we can't harm any embryo or to germinate them, or they are failed to germinate. So this is the embryo rescue, okay, and it is an important method for plant breeding and the crop hybrids. Now there are the some factors that involved in embryo rescue, like media, which media we use. We can use MS media, or we can use nutrient medium, or white media, or brown media. Okay, that is depend upon the type of media. Next one is temperature and light. See, temperature and light, these are the conditional, or we say that these are the controlled condition in which plant will grow. Okay, that temperature and light will affect the plant, and we can provide this, or we can control this temperature and light according to the species, which species or which plant culture we did. Okay, then next is the time of culture. Here the culturing of time is very necessary, like we are doing culturing, but the environmental conditions are not appropriate, or the controlled conditions are not appropriate, and we are doing culturing, then our culture will be fail. So the time of culture must be exact or must be appropriate according to the plant species. Now there are the two type of embryo culture. First one is mature embryo culture, and second one is immature embryo culture. So what is mature embryo culture? Mature embryos are isolated from the ripe seed and cultured in vitro condition. So this type of culture is done when embryo do not survive in vivo and become dormant for long period of time, or is done to eliminate the inhibition of the seed germination. Okay. Now there are the some factor, or we say that these are the some reasons for carrying the mature embryo culture. First, when the embryo remain dormant for long period. Second, low survival of embryo in vivo conditions. Then to avoid the inhibitions in the seed for germination. Then for converting sterile seed to viable seedling. There are the some species produce sterile seed, which may be due to incomplete embryo development. Okay, and such embryos can be cultured and viable seedling can be produced. For example, iris and orchid. And there are the some seed dormancy of many species that is due to the chemical inhibitor or mechanical resistance that present in the structure of covering the embryo, rather than dormancy of the embryonic tissues. Okay, so next one is immature embryo. Immature embryo, it is the culture of immature embryo to rescue the embryo of wide crosses, and is used to avoid the embryo abortion and produce viable plant. So this is mainly used to avoid the embryo abortion and with the purpose of producing a viable plant. So wide hybridization, where the individual from the two different species of the same genus or different genera are crossed and often led to failure. So there are the survival barrier, which operate at pre and post fertilization level to prevent the successful gene transfer from the wild into the cultivated species. So it required the complex media, which includes special amino acids, hormones, endosperm extract like coconut milk and etc. Now culturing of embryo, there are the two main steps for culturing the embryo. First one is excision of embryo, and second one is the culture requirement. Okay, now how we excise the embryo? So this is the main step for culturing the embryo. We can do it very carefully. First, what we done, we collect the material that after pollination of freshly opened flower is necessary when embryos are to be cultured at the specific stage of development. So the mature embryos can be isolated by splitting open the seed, and the seed with hard seed coat are dissected after soaking them in water. See, there are the some plants we are having the hard seed coat, like sunflower and castor, they having the hard seed coat. So what can we do? We can soak the seed into the water, and after 2 to 4 hours or after overnight, then they will be removed or dissected easily without harming the embryo. Now to excise immature embryo from single ovule, the ovule is split longitudinally to isolate the half containing the embryo, and for excising old embryo A small incision is made in the ovule on the side lacking the embryo, and then a slight pressure is applied with a blunt needle to release the intact embryo. You can see here, this one is the self-pollination. Now, after this pollination, this immature fruit just harvested and the opening will be done. Okay, then the fruit and the seed are fertilized. After fertilization, embryo are excised, and the different stages of embryo, that is the identification. You can see here, this one is the embryo. So you can identify the embryo here in vitro sowing, and then the embryo development and germination. After this embryo excision, embryo will be developed and germinate, and then what will happen? Plantlet evaluation we can do after when we do culturing. The plants will be evaluated, and then these are ready for the assimilations. Okay, this plant will be ready for the assimilation. After having this identification, we will isolate them into the culture plates, and after culturing, the plantlet will be ready for the assimilation. Now you can also see in this diagram that the embryo Lens clunaris and the wild Lens species, we cross both of them. We have in the pod age, that is the 14 days. Then the embryo attached with the ovules after removal the integument, and then after 2 weeks embryo will be germinate, and we culture this embryo, the germinate cultural, germinate the embryo, and after germination healthy haploid plantlet develop after 3 to 4 weeks of the culture. And in this culture media is IAA media, and then we have the perform well shoot regeneration. We can add the shoot hormone, then we add the root hormone, so the root elongate, or then the shoot multiply, and in the end we have the interspecific hybrid plantlet that derived from the single zygotic embryo. Now what are the cultural requirement? The most important aspect of embryo culture is the selection of a suitable medium that would progressive and orderly development of embryo excised at different stages of development. So the zygotic embryo developed through the following stages. Which one? First one is the proembryo, then the globular stage, heart-shaped stage, torpedo stage, and the cotyledonary stage. These are the main stages of the zygotic embryo. Okay, you can see here, see, first we select the immature seed, and after selection the sterilization will be done. When the sterilized seeds are sterilized, the peeling of the glumes. Peeling of the glume means we can dissect the seeds, remove the hard coat of the seed coat, remove the hard seed coat, and we having the embryo. We excise this embryo, placing the embryo on the medium, then the growth of embryo into the seed, that we can leave it for overnight, and after that what will happen, plantlets after a week will germinate, and the plantlet now ready to transplant it to the soil, and after 2 weeks of the old seedling we can germinate it into the pods. Okay, now a fully developed embryo undergo a maturation during which the embryo hard. Okay, for example, that is the globular stage in the capsule of the embryo is heterotrophic, so as it derives some part of the nutrition from endosperm. Then beyond these stages, the embryo become autotrophic and is able to synthesize its biochemical need from simple nutrients like salt and sugar. Okay, so the most aspect of embryo culture work is the selection of the medium. Necessary is the media that sustain to continue the growth of the embryo. So in most cases of the standardable basal plant growth medium with the major salt and trace elements may be utilized, and the mature embryo can be grown in basal salt medium with a carbon energy source such as sucrose, and but the young embryos in addition require different vitamins, amino acids and growth regulator, and in some cases natural endosperm extract. So young embryo should be transferred to a medium with a high sucrose concentration, that is 8 to 12%, and then which approximate the high osmotic potential of the intracellular stages. Okay, so the osmotic potential of the intracellular environment of the young embryo sac and a combination of hormones which support the growth of a heart stage. See, this is our culturing. We complete our culturing here. Now there we summarize this all culture in the four step. First we collect the mature zygotic embryo in the field, then in step second in vitro culturing will be done. In vitro culturing, what will then we place them on sterilized semi-solid growth medium, establish them, grow them, rooting them. Okay, then third step is the adaptation. Now in adaptation, transfer the plantulate in sterilized soil under high humidity, and that is 26 plus minus 1 degree Celsius temperature with different growing inductor to increase the efficiency of the radial system. And in the last step, that is the fourth step, transfer the plantulates in polythene bags under nursery conditions. Okay, so these are the steps that are used for the culturing, embryo culturing or embryo rescue. Okay, so we can summarize this all culturing in this four step. Now the nutritional requirement. Okay, there are the different type of nutritional requirement for the embryo culture. First we need carbohydrate, so sucrose is the best carbon source and produce energy and also maintain suitable osmolarity. For mature embryo grow well with 2% sucrose. Younger embryo grow well with high level of sucrose concentration, as we discussed earlier, that is 8 to 12%. Okay, which approximate having the high osmotic potential of the intracellular environment of the young embryonic sac, and a combination of hormones also we need for this, that reduce the moderate level of auxin and low level of cytokinin. And the heart shaped embryo use mannitol at 120 gram per liter is suitable. Okay, then the amino acids and vitamins that reduce the nitrogen in the form of glutamine and aspargine is beneficial, particularly for the younger embryo. Then third one is mineral salt, that monoamines modify the MS media and it favor high survival rate of cultural immature embryos. Okay, and the last one is the natural plant product. See, Vannevar Beek and his co-worker reported the importance of coconut milk, that is the liquid endosperm of coconut, and promoting the growth of certain immature embryos. Okay, now next one is the growth regulator. See, the auxin and cytokinin are not necessarily used in the embryo culture, since the embryos are usually autotrophic because it having the moderate level of auxin and a low level of cytokinin. So it is not necessary in this respect. ABA, that is the abscisic acid, check precocious germination and promoted embryo development and maturation. We can also see here that the medium pH of the medium is critical for the organic differentiation, and the range of the pH growth of excised embryo is 5 to 7.5. Cultural environment, we need the temperature that is ranging from 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius, and the embryo develop into the plantulate in 14 to 30 days. So it is therefore the appropriate media that we use for the culturing growth. Okay, other than this, we can use the aspargine, glutamine or hydrolate, that is also beneficial for the embryo culture. We can use malic acid, that is added to the embryo culture medium. Okay, so these are the main source that are used in the embryo culture media. Okay, now next one is the application of embryo culture. See, prevention of embryo abortion. Now how will we prevent? See, the having the successful interspecific hybrid, which like seen in the cotton, barley, tomato, rice, legume, flax, and the well known intragenic hybrid including the wheat and barley, wheat and rye, barley and rye, maize and trapiscum. These all are the intragenic hybrid. Now the distant hybrid have also been obtained via embryo rescue, and the embryo rescue technique has been successfully used for raising the hybrid like embryos between the Actinidia deliciosa and the Actinidia erinthea, and also the Actodynia deliceus and the Arguetta. Okay, so embryo rescue from a cross between an early Japanese Sungo vase and the Chinese Yuvalava and the obtained Joxylus and extra early maturing peach cultivar. So it mature in 55 days. Okay, so some of the hybrid plant raised by the embryo culture have recombined desirable genes such as earliness, disease and pest resistance, and this embryo culture is also used in crosses between the diploid and the tetraploid forms. Again, next one is the overcoming of the seed dormancy. See, embryo culture technique is applied to break seed dormancy. So seed dormancy can be caused by the numerous factors including the endogenous inhibitors, specific light requirement, okay, and other than this, like low temperature, dry storage requirement, embryo immaturity. So this factor can be circumvented by the embryo excision and culture. So seed dormancy in Eris is due to the presence of stable chemical inhibitor in the endosperm, and same does it is difficult to germinate seed of the species, and by excising this embryo, germination occurred without delay at all the stages of seed maturity. So it is a potential technique that is used in the producing the seedling from seed of naturally vegetative propagated plant to the like a banana, and whose seed do not germinate in nature. So probably due to recalcitrant dormancy or embryo culture technique may also thus be capable to producing the viable seedling in this species. So seed dormancy is an important aspect for the embryo culture. So the embryo culture will overcome this seed dormancy. Next one is the shortening of breeding cycle. See, shortening of breeding cycle many species that exhibit the seed dormancy is often localized in the seed coat and in the endosperm. So by removing this inhibition, seed germinate immediately using some time take up water and oxygen very slowly or not all through the seed coat, and so germinate very slowly. Okay, so there are the some immature heart shaped fruits having reached maturity. So under proper germination conditions, they are required to for the seed that mature the berries or to complete the embryonic development and to begin germination. So the excised embryo go through all the development sequences in vitro and can obtained in 2 to 3 weeks a time. So these are the normal embryo culture that can be possibly to produce the two generation in an year. Then the production of haploids. Production of haploids that the embryo culture can be utilized in the production of haploids or monoploids. So one of the scientists like Keshav and the Khao are reported a novel technique for the production of haploid in barley. He did the technique to produce barley and monoploids actually. So the intraspecific crosses are made with Hordeum vulgare and the Hordeum bulbosum. So the parents and the resulting hybrid are cultured, but the exhibit Hordeum bulbosum, then the chromosome elimination will be done, that having the young embryo 7 and the female parent resulting in the monoplant female parent, that is the Hordeum vulgare. Okay, it means the cross Hordeum vulgare cross with the Hordeum bulbosum having the chromosome number diploid chromosome number 14, they gave rise to the zygote. And this zygote is the Hordeum vulgare female part. It eliminate the Hordeum bulbosum that having the young embryo, and then the embryo culture and the double chromosome doubling will be done, and in the end we having the haploid plant of Hordeum vulgare. Okay, so it can produce the haploid more easily. Then overcoming the seed sterility, it can overcome the seed sterility. Okay. Then again here are the some example of overcoming seed dormancy, like Eris seed may take 2 to 7 years to germinate. Then shortening of the breeding cycle, like rose plant take normally 1 year to come to flowering, but embryo culture, through embryo culture it can plant flowering in the 6 months. Okay, and in the propagation of rare plant, like example banana, propagation of orchids like orchids, देन प्रिवेंशन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो एबॉर्शन लाइक अर्ली रिपेयरिंग वेराइटीज स्पीच चेरीज ठीक है क्लोनल मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड द रैपिड सीड वायबिलिटी टेस्ट दिज आर द क्लोनल प्रपोगेशन शोविंग द बेटर रिजल्ट इन द एम्ब्रियो कल्चर यू कैन सी हेयर वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई दिस एडिंग हॉर्मोन्स रूट हॉर्मोन शूट हॉर्मोन एंड इट इज़ रेडी टू गो टू द नर्सरीज और टू द फील्ड फॉर फर्दर प्रोडक्शन then the precocious germination see the precocious germination means now here the different type of germination like seeds are germinate in vitro clonal propagation so they are specially like the conifers or the member of the gramini family actually so the seeds that are sterile will not germinate under appropriate conditions so eventually decay in soil example the ripening of varieties of fruit Okay, so then seed sterility may be due to incomplete embryos. Now here the polyembryony, it means that having the incomplete embryo which result the death of the germination of the embryo. So in crosses of early ripening stone fruits like the transport of water, nutrient or the immature embryos, sometime cut off too soon resulting in the abortion of the embryo. So this embryo culture has been practiced as general method in horticulture crop and then the embryos are excellent material for in vitro clonal propagation. Germination of seeds is obligatory parasites without the host is impossible in vivo but is achievable with the embryo culture. So the development next is from the embryo culture there are the useful in evolving disease resistant plant for example tomato resistant to virus fungi and nematode we are having the example like lycopersicum cross with the perviinum okay then the potato give rise to the it is resistant to potato leaf roll virus then the solanum tuberosum crosses with the solanum tuberosum okay at E. tuberosum so these are the main examples showing the disease resistant plant with the help of embryo culture now the disadvantages of embryo culture the disadvantages of embryo culture showing that the number of hybrid seedling rescued in many instances is extremely low due to difficulty in growing very young embryos then the viability decreases with the age of embryo in most of the incompatible crosses and the efforts are needed to identify requirements for embryo for progressively younger stage in the mesocrop species so these are the some disadvantages of cross embryo culture other than this embryo culture is very beneficial for the production of hybrid plant or for the production of many new varieties so now students after hearing this lecture I think you all are able to go through these questions and you are able to give answers of these questions so thank you sir very much for hearing me thank you so much